Hello, welcome to Connie Martinson Talks Books. Although all America knows my guest as Professor Kingsfield from the paper Chase, he truly has been a Renaissance man of theater, beginning with the Mercury Playhouse to the Seven Lively Arts on television to producer of Julius Caesar, Bad and the Beautiful, some of the great classics of our entertainment in the United States and around the world. Well, he has written a book called The Entertainers and the Entertained. It is a series of essays and pieces that he has written through the years, but it now has the added touch of looking back as a foreword to each of the pieces. We will be back after a short pause with my guest, John Houseman, author of The Entertainers and the Entertained, published by Simon & Schuster. Welcome back. We're talking with John Houseman, author of Entertainers and the Entertained, published by Simon & Schuster. Welcome, John.
Thank you.
And Entertainers and the Entertained is a marvelous sort of an hors d'oeuvres of all of your works through the years, beginning with the Mercury Playhouse, which
going even before that. The Federal Theater, yes.
Yes. And the marvelous story, and let's sort of as Will Graze this book, the story of Richard Wright and Native Son. I felt reading that piece, it was also gave me a sociological view of America at that point, of a book that in many ways changed the image of the black man and woman in America.
Yes, it did.
And what the transformation from the book to the play and his almost reticence of saying, I am who I am.
Well, he was actually a very sophisticated young man. He had been a communist at one time. And he wrote this book, obviously out of great passion. And when Paul Green adapted it, and Paul Green was the right man to do it, he'd written some very distinguished plays about black life, but he would not entirely accept the thesis on which Dick Wright had written that book, which was that at that time, a young black man simply could not find his place in the world except as a subservient character. And that finally, the way he found himself by accident was through this terrible murder, which Dick did not condone. Mm-hmm. But the circumstances that followed this murder made it possible for this young man finally to express himself in the white world. He had to go to the electric chair. He had committed a killing, involuntary, but there it was. But he finally faced the world as an equal, so to speak, instead of as a subservient character.
Now, you and your mother drive him up from the South, and the scene, too, where you go into a restaurant and the owner will not allow a black man to be served, and you're three blocks from the White House.
That's right. Well, it was not just a small restaurant. It was a great big, it was one of the big chains of restaurants. And, of course, I should have known better because in Washington, D.C., there was total segregation at that time. And we sort of snuck in, and it's amazing that they even served him, but they wouldn't let him eat it there. So we ate it on the sidewalk.
And now, and your mother, who's European, doesn't understand any of this sort of
behavior. It's all absolutely bewildering.
Yeah, like going to the jungles.
What are they talking about?
Now you're in New York, and the play is to be performed. And you realize that Paul Green has lost maybe the essence of what Richard Wright wrote. So you sit down and you do rewrite it with Wright. And you said something, you called in Orson Welles to direct and you had sworn you would never do it again, and yet this was a different chance.
Well, it was our last, I wanted our last show together to be a triumph. And I knew that this was going to be a very distinguished production. I also knew, in spite of the fact that I wanted very badly to direct it, I knew that Orson would make it more dramatic and more exciting than I could. So there was no hesitation. I invited Orson to in and we produced it together, and it was the last show we ever did.
Mm-hmm. The show opened to terrific reviews.
Oh yes, very good. Mm-hmm. But it was interesting because just before the show opened, we were picketed. And we were picketed by two quite different elements, by the Urban League, which was a very conservative black organization, and by the Communist Party. So everybody picketed us.
Called a plague on both your houses. Right. Stratford, you do a series of essays in this book about the beginning of the Stratford Theater in Connecticut.
That was the 4 years that I was there, yes.
And ending with the fact there was never a fifth season. But you bring out something in this book I had not read or thought about, John, the use of a festival of theater in America.